Sonia Denise, she's in Atlanta.
She's welcoming her godson, or is it goddaughter? Godson, into the world. Oh, I can't wait to see some pictures.
It's exciting. Lorelli's about to have her baby, too.
Oh, my gosh. She's so little. Just, ah.
C-section, girl. C-section.
All these babies.
Don't bust that poo-poom open.
Okay. You don't want that. Keep it intact.
Right, everyone's having babies, and we're over here like bottle.
I'd rather have that than a baby bottle. Shit. Yes. So, how's everything been going?
It's your birthday.
It's not today.
Well, it was a week ago, or almost like 10
about a week ago.
We're in Pisces season, you guys.
Yes. Pisces. I had fun for my birthday.
Yeah.
I went to Miami, Turks and Caicos. I got a little tan. gained a little weight, drinking, nonstop drinking. That's why this is probably like, I haven't drunk since I gotten back.
Yeah.
And this is like, it feels hard.
Yeah, it's hard to drink.
But I'm going to drink it anyway.
What did you do out there?
Drink, eat. We went to, Noah's Ark. Uh-huh. That's like in the middle of the ocean.
Did you get in the ocean?
A little bit. I kind of fell in. I tried to do a little photo shoot, and it was so funny. And then the photographer, they was like, put your arms back like this. And I couldn't understand. I was like, huh?
Huh? What?
He was like, and then I had to look up into the sun. Oh, I should have sent a picture in, but I'll show it later. And then maybe by the end of the show, I have a picture up. I have to look up into the sun, and I'm like, I can't see. I'm blind. Like, he's like, look up, because it was a drone flying over, and I took it in a little boat, you know, the little one everybody do.
Yeah.
And I was like, I can't see, though. And he was like, look up. I was like, ha.
Dang.
So it was just funny. But, yeah, it was.
I'm scared of those oceans because there'd be a lot of sharks in there. Like the Bahamas and stuff. Like, if you can't jump in the ocean over there.
I know. Don't jump
in. Even Miami, they showed, like, not far from the shore was oceans.
Yeah, they're coming up on the shore. Like, these sharks don't give two fucks.
No, isn't that weird that nowadays they're more closer to the shore? Like, what does that tell us about the ocean?
Uh-oh.
That they're running out of food? Or what?
Here we go.
I'm just saying, I don't get in the ocean.
To get us.
I jumped in the ocean one time when I was in Hawaii, and I literally just went in there for like 2 minutes and hopped right back on the boat. I was like, no, I'm not doing
that
it.
That is scary.
Just in the middle of the ocean just seems like you just never know. Something's dangling under you. Like.
Right. I used to be a big fan of Jaws when I was little, too. Them sharks just coming out of nowhere. And it's always like a party or something. Everybody having a good time. Or when people are having sex in the water or something like that, you know.
How could you have sex in the ocean in the middle of the ocean?
Girl, it's doable.
Shoot. Maybe a jacuzzi, not the ocean.
Yeah, the ocean.
Get the salt water in your ass.
But whatever, you know. Whenever, wherever.
Okay, Pisces season.
Yes, yay. Thank you for the balloons. She got me balloons.
I know, though. It looks all sparkly so back there. It is.
It's so cute.
And I got her some party favors.
Oh, yeah. Love it. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yes, but girl, have you seen that new movie, Mea Culpa?
Oh, my gosh, girl. I'm jealous of that movie. I'm jealous of that movie.
Kelly Rowland, she plays Mea Culpa. What's this?
Is she married?
That's a picture.
Is she married in real life?
Yeah, she's married.
I don't know.
I thought it was a video. I'm like, what's that? What's happening to her? I'm looking like this.
How could someone's husband? I would be into my role if I was with that Trevante Rhodes girl. I'm not pretending.
It's a movie.
I'm not pretending. Fuck it.
You're not supposed to pretend. You gonna fuck him for real?
Didn't they say Halle Berry fucked
Billy Bob?
Yeah, that's why she got Oscar? Because she actually really fucked him. It was a real sex scene. Like, to me, that makes it real. But Halle Berry, I don't think, was married at the time. You know? But Billy Bob's kind of hot. But Trevante Rhodes? Oh,
Billy
no.
Billy Bob. Remember when Billy Bob Thornton was with Angelina Jolie? They were, like, obsessed with it. I thought that was cute, but it's just kind of weird. I don't know.
Yeah, it was. It seemed like they were just into some raunchy shit. Like, yeah. Angelina definitely is a dominatrix kind of woman.
I guarantee you they had sex in the ocean.
Oh, my gosh. So they went front. They were.
Yeah, that everybody was like, wait a minute, what's going on? Because they both married. But they're co-stars.
So this was before the movie was released or during?
After. This was after.
Oh, no.
They're just all having fun.
Well, I'm going to your trailer afterwards. Ain't nobody got to know. He is just, come on.
Sophia, why are you always trying to go to somebody's trailer?
No. I mean, not everybody's trailer, but that man right there, he's a 210.
She got a whole plate of food. Hey, I thought I'd make you some goodies and stuff.
I mean, you get a pass if you're Kelly Rowland. I'm sorry.
That's so funny.
But what do you think about it?
Them
on the sex scene.
I thought it was hot. I thought it was sexy, you know. I never found, like, Kelly to be, like, real sexy, you know. But I think she brought it out. Come on in. What's happening? What's up? Sporty Barbie.
Hey,
what's up? Like,
we're like.
She can sit over there.
Oh, wherever.
Yeah, go over there.
You want me to sit by you?
You want to sit by me?
Yes, I never get to.
We sharing a camera today, guys.
You can sit over there.
I mean, doesn't the guest normally sit right here?
I don't know.
I never
this
get to.
This side shows my dimple better.
Oh, ooh. She said. Wow, look. Okay, now we got to be the same size because now I look bigger.
You want to go over there? Fine, I'll go over there.
Well, no, I'm talking about the frame.
Oh. Yeah.
Calm down.
You need to zoom in. Zoom in.
Honestly,
zoom in on these titties.
I'm going back over there. I don't feel want to.
Wait a minute.
I'm just leaving.
Why are you going? You done pissed her off.
Because I said zoom in on the titties. You can't share the titties, but he's going to be over here.
Then?
That was his
cup.
I need a shot or two.
We know. We got
or
you.
Three
girl.
Or
we
four. Or five you. Or six.
Okay. So we were just talking about the new movie by Tyler Perry called Mea Culpa, right? Have you seen it yet?
Oh, no.
No?
I started it, but I
you started it? You didn't finish? Oh, that girl.
I'm so jealous of that movie.
Did you see the clip about the little paint sex scene? They had paint all over their body and stuff.
Did they show his dick?
They show his booty.
Later we want to see the size of that penis.
I want to see me up there.
Yeah, they didn't show that part, but they showed, you know, quite a bit. I was actually shocked. But anyways, yeah.
We trying to see people's thing-a-lang-a-lang, especially Trevante Rhodes, okay? Like,
what if it ends up being a little thing?
I highly doubt it. I highly. Even if he was a 7, he's just so fine that it doesn't even matter.
He seems really confident, so it might be something. It might be a little something there. Did you guys see my girl Riri?
Oh, being pregnant at that Indian billionaire party?
So Rihanna had to take a trip to Dubai because she was requested by a billionaire's to perform at a pre-wedding ceremony that they were given. So, and she pregnant and all. She was like, hell yeah, this girl ain't performed since, what, the Super Bowl? But, like, we got a little clip of her and her little performance with her belly.
Lucky her. I'm sure she got paid the fuck up.
Hell yeah.
I think it was like $24 million or something like
what?
That.
What? She was like, hold on, baby. Let's get this money real quick.
Okay. She looks gorgeous.
Did she confirm this?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, when? How?
When was this? This was right after the she had the baby, like 6 weeks, maybe.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe.
Having it pop these babies out so fast.
That's crazy. I couldn't. I need a break. Oh, they can hear us, huh? Let that coochie breathe.
That's just one of the best type of performances to have, though, is for those rich Indian billionaires. Like,
see, and that's what
they probably took care of her so well.
I commend Riri because she don't play about her money. She like, you know what? I ain't doing this little
she'll
shit.
She'll come out. She'll come out for the right things.
Hell yeah.
The important things.
Remember, we were trying to get her for.
Oh yeah, for the Africa. For the rich African guy. Mm-hmm. He only offered her $600,000. Only $600,000.
She was like, hell no. What do right. I look like a peasant?
But that's
you?
When she was dating a billionaire. That was before ASAP Rocky. But so I mean like, I would have took that $600,000 for 20 minutes or whatever just to walk. She wouldn't it wasn't even a performance. He just wanted her to show up.
Not Riri. She said she don't bitch better have my
yeah,
money.
She was with that billionaire already. Then she had the Fenty going on. That was like the beginning of Fenty, so yeah, she didn't need it, but I mean, that's the beauty about being famous is that you get offers from all these other rich people in different countries just to hang out. Because Kim right. Kardashian was getting money from this rich Asian guy who was a gambler in her beginning of her celebrity, like millions of dollars just to show up to Vegas. Ooh. So these bitches
wasn't,
is all.
Wasn't Rihanna dating some guy from like Dubai or something?
Yeah, the billionaire.
A long time ago?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. They was all up in a jacuzzi. I was like, okay, who's this? Then he was gone. I was like, what the fuck? What happened? It's something about, okay, speaking of rich billionaires, we got some stuff that's going on. So, Portia. Oh, Portia Lord. Williams. Okay, remember she got married to Simon. I can't what? Pronounce his last name. Okay, so they got married. I remember the wedding like I was there. She had like 2 or 3 weddings. And she was like the happiest person because... You know, she
got all the
she
money.
She got that nigga with the money. All the money. She was, I never seen her smiling so much and dancing so hard.
But she don't seem sad at
but
all.
But come
right
to
now.
Find out he was a scammer. She probably got everything she could.
But you think she even feel like sad about it?
She probably feels dumb, I think.
Well,
but
she's a
no,
little
she
sad.
Claudia. She set it up.
She set it up? Oh. Now they're going through a divorce.
That's what Tasha K said.
And then they're saying
Yeah, that's messy
because they got a prenup or whatever, but they're going through their divorce. He's trying to win her back, but it comes out that he's a big time scammer and always knew them.
Not but didn't they already Africans. Know this? They already
they
knew
be
this.
Trying to act like they
well,
got
his
billions.
Ex-wife Fallon was the one who was like, you know, well, he's, you know, that's all scam money. You're running off with my husband, like you're running off with the bag, but like it's not because I guess he hasn't been able to get citizenship in America, which right. is why he keeps going over. Overseas, but ever since she posted that she's divorcing him, he's been posting his Rolls Royces and posting all these designer cars, and it's just like, what are you trying to show? Like, you know, if you are
he's trying to set up for his next wife, he gotta get that citizenship in order. Like,
but it just comes to show when you go on TV, you have to have all your ducks in order because that's when you're gonna end up getting in trouble if you were like scamming,
back.
You know? Because he was under the radar before he got with Portia.
Yeah,
you know, and she like and people up. Like the lifestyle, you know, they mm-hmm. want to brag about, oh, look what I have, look where I'm at, you know, and it's just like not always good, especially if the money's dirty.
Yep. And that money was filthy. Yes. So and now Portia, she's kind of concerned because she's like, shit, some of this shit is in my name, you know, and she doesn't want no part of it. So she's trying to rectify the whole situation and keep her name in the clear. So, you know. At least she got nice pictures of her wedding, I guess. I don't know.
I mean, I don't know. It's messy, but at the end of the day, it's like a lot of guys who have money like that had to do some type of scamming at some point, like some type of money laundry. I think everybody that was a super filthy rich did some type of underground something. Government stuff. They all do dirty money.
What if they got it from their daddy when their daddy died?
The daddy was doing something then.
Somebody just had to be doing
somebody
something.
Somebody was doing some money laundry or some selling drugs or whatever the fuck. Like,
daddy was a doughboy.
But I mean, she couldn't even get him a green card, you know? And it's just so embarrassing. It's just so, and she don't have no kids with him, right? Or does she?
No.
She should have stayed with that that hot dog guy, because he at least had legal money.
The hot dog guy.
The guy who was slanging hot dogs in Atlanta. The one who had a few restaurants, but it was hot dog restaurants. I mean, it wasn't billionaire money, but it still was like legal
hot
money.
Dog.
You know?
He got hot dog money.
Slanging
shit.
Hot dogs.
Because he was buying her slanging jewelry and shit like that. I mean, every girl wants to be spoiled. So this guy said green card moves.
Okay. Now, and I was just seeing Dream Doll, she had posted a video. She went to Dubai with her new little boo. He's a soccer player, Quincy. So she posted this video. They were having such a look, and he's so cute. Look at him. Okay, chocolate.
Another scammer.
What he talking about? See, it's not red flag number one. He talking about shush, don't tell nobody. He's up to something. Okay, so he got caught in Dubai smuggling, cocaine?
It was somewhere else. He got caught in, Norway or something like that.
Right, and he was on...
He was on the run.
He was on the run?
Yeah, he was already convicted somewhere. And
who,
then he
this
went
guy?
Yeah. They already convicted him of six Stop years of daddy. Smuggling drugs, and then he traveled to Dubai. When you become with someone who's in the limelight, your moves start being noticed, and now he was detained in Dubai for something else, and then they're going to probably... transport him to wherever he has that charge at. And it's like, once you become like transport. It's like once you want, like, you're a famous soccer player too, like, why are you smuggling drugs?
Like, that's what I was saying. I was like, isn't the soccers, they get paid,
but you know, they go on private jets, so it's easy to put cocaine in your bag and you not get caught until someone tells on you. You know, I'm sure that's what happened.
Dang.
You know, but it's just like everybody wants to be with someone in the limelight until it happens, and then all your dirt gets exposed.
See, all these men are just some scam artists.
They just need to not be doing that shit.
Yeah, just don't do it. Just
then
don't.
What they gonna do? They
have your boys do it. Have you ever watched Locked Up Abroad? Like, that shit is no fucking joke. Okay,
you gotta do something out here. It's hard. It's hard.
You know, it's hard out here for a pimp.
Speaking of pimps, you know what? We got somebody outside. He's a pimp. He's a straight pimp. So we going to have Mr. Patrick come
the
on
pimp.
Through.
That is a good Patrick name. Pimp, Patrick pimp. The
we,
pimp.
We're some pimp pimp.
Patrick the pimp.
I know he's not out there asleep. Patrick!
Don't get knocked off. We did not roofie you.
See, I told you shouldn't have given that. She's always trying to get somebody drunk, so I don't know. He out
there
you want
laid this?
Out.
You want some, oh, want some wine?
Yes, I want it all, please.
You want it all?
You know what was all doing? Out here for a pimp.
What's up? We got Patrick Mill.
Sexy.
There you go, darling.
Yeah, she kicked me out that seat. Before
I won't
you
roast.
Yeah, she wanted you to sit there.
I want to sit next to my baby.
Yeah. Mister, you didn't even hear us.
What
he ain't
Patrick
no
the Pimp Neil.
Oh.
You didn't see? Did you see your entrance?
Talk to me. Now I'm a pimp,
you know, next to the tits.
But I don't slap my chicks.
Ass titties.
I don't slap my chicks, you know what I'm saying?
No? You never slapped a woman ever in your life?
No, I slapped
Have you been slapped?
I don't know.
I was about to say, I said,
no, have a woman slapped you?
No, that's not. That's okay. That's one thing I always tell them. No, for real, I tell them, I say, you know, you can't do the, this the money maker. You can hit all this shit.
Okay.
But you can't slap
So you never hurt a woman, you never broke her heart, and she never got mad at you?
Nah, I'm so good with women. I don't really, you know.
Clap for that.
Okay. I treat them right. Okay. You know what I'm saying? I slap the ass, though.
We need some referrals. We're going to talk to your ex.
Yeah.
Just contradict the whole thing. Just
actually, we got an ex on the phone right now.
You didn't know, damn. Did you?
Hold up. Is that
hello.
You, Kim?
Hello.
Yeah, I did slap Kim.
Everybody got an ex named Kim. What is going on? We need new names.
Kim was my baby, too. She was my baby.
Everybody his baby. That's my baby.
Damn.
That's
Yo,
my
you,
baby.
You number one, though. This is
oh, really?
One
oh, now she's number one.
He's saying this is number one,
number one A and B.
So right?
I see.
It's a group package. Is that what it is?
That's what's up. What's up, Sparkle?
What's happening? How you
been? Good to see y'all, man. I'm good.
Good to see you, too.
Yeah, I'm amazing. I'm living life.
What you been up to?
Everything, you know, staying out the way. Just trying to make sure that, you know, I'm shooting my comedy special in a month and a half, but I'm keeping it private. I don't really want everybody to know about it. So it's only a select few that can come through.
Are we on the list?
Of course. Okay. Y'all my people, of course.
Okay.
Yeah,
just
easy.
Making sure. You know what I'm saying? We would love to be there to support.
I would definitely appreciate it, too.
Yeah.
Because y'all my people.
You be everywhere.
He does.
Everywhere.
He
I do.
Does.
It seems like I'm everywhere.
Between you and Sporty,
he
you
be at
everywhere.
My cousin's
he's
house.
He's saying the same thing every time we
everything.
See
you everywhere. What's up?
Yeah, she, you too. She everywhere. Yeah.
Both of y'all.
You everywhere I'm at.
Well, that's true.
We need to start getting some invites.
I think we connected. You know what I'm saying? Through telepathically. Yeah.
She said.
We connected, but it seemed like I'm everywhere because I be posting, but I post like, I'll get some stuff and I'll post like 2-3 months later.
Yeah.
So
okay.
I'd be at the crib chilling. You know what I'm saying? So
like, where
I really
you at?
Don't be out like that. I'll be out there every now and then.
Yeah.
You know?
Sometimes you got to live in the moment. You
yeah,
know?
Yeah, mm-hmm. yeah. I like to post late. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. So, see, people be getting mad at me because I don't be posting.
Like, yeah, they like you to post when you come out. That's why.
Yeah.
If you post, they love that. You know?
Yeah. They do.
I'm trying to get better at it.
You going to come with me next time? You
going
to be on the red
like,
carpet? Can
yours?
I roll with y'all like this? On
like,
the red
what?
Carpet? You grab this arm.
So you can really look like a pimp?
No, it ain't going to be a pimp. It's going to be love. Cause you
can
know
hold
saying,
my
y'all
bag.
My people. You know, no, y'all kidding. My people.
What's that one guy's name that we did an interview with? Boo Capone?
Oh,
my gosh, y'all. I saw him. Oh, my God.
What happened?
Where I see him at?
Oh,
Busta Rhymes thing. Was you there?
I ain't go. I saw it. I was supposed to be there.
Busta Rhymes and Scarlett was there. It was, I can't remember the
name. Oh,
did he try to clown you or something?
No, I turned around and he was behind me all whispering all up in my ear.
Oh.
That's he was talking a lot.
I'm on TV.
He was trying to get you on the track.
I said, what's that? Remember me? He goes, yeah, I remember.
Booby banging, like blood club.
Yeah,
blood,
that's what he was saying.
Blood club, hey, nigga, stop that.
I'm like, what? Okay.
Stop all that, man. We at the comedy club. What you doing, boo?
I was like, what
are
you doing behind
me? We ain't on the street. Chill out.
He's funny. He's
he be banging on everybody. What you
he
say,
don't
blood?
Care. Hey,
bro, we at the comedy
he
club.
He calls the Real Housewives of Section 8.
He's crazy.
Boo wait,
crazy.
What?
Boo crazy, too, man. And that's my dog, too. I love you, boo. I love
we
you,
need
boy.
Some Section 8 out here with all this high-ass rent we got in
oh,
L.A.
Come
the
on.
List is long.
Too. Rent, mortgage,
to
everything.
That. They don't
high.
Let nobody join that Section 8 list.
Man,
oh, you
tough.
Just want to drink to
oh,
anything.
Want
I drink to
oh,
that.
Do it? Is it your cup?
No, no, this one's yours. Do you want another
I
one?
Wanted to make sure it was your cup. Like,
oh, I've been sipping on it. My bad, Sparkle.
You want my cup?
Yeah,
what?
I've been sipping on oh, I thought we was going to take it together. All right.
We can sell it.
I
want to
mess with your
day.
Boyfriends, though. I want to mess with
you.
Wait,
yeah, no. It's okay, baby. I'm not mad at that.
I got too many boyfriends.
She said,
I got too many boyfriends.
I'm not mad at your boyfriend.
I'm innocent.
I'm not a hater.
Between me and Tony, we don't. No, Tony's married.
Oh, Tony,
I'm not gonna
see,
do that.
That is, you know, marriage is cool. See, marriage.
What? You
marriage
got a wedding ring
not.
On?
That, no, that's not wedding. That's
is that
not
a pimp ring?
That's just saying I'm married to myself. You know.
No,
what I'm
saying? You ain't doing.
I'm married to the game.
Who got married to themselves?
I'm married
Maya.
To the game.
Married to the game.
I'm married to the game.
Didn't Maya marry herself? Remember
oh, the Maya the singer?
Yeah, she
Maya,
married herself.
Maya been in the tunnel.
Wait, that's
she,
real?
She,
that's for real?
She Maya, did,
Maya
yeah.
Been in the
that's
cave.
What I heard. She
Maya,
married
Maya.
But, you know, I really
I
think
Maya.
About it. Who she with? Who has she been with?
Jay-Z.
Whoa.
That's the first
that.
One.
I didn't know that.
Dang, that was way
it's
back.
Your boy so
who
crazy,
else?
Jay the Pimp.
Maya is such a gem. Like, she's so
she
beautiful.
Really
I love
is.
Her.
She's so beautiful still. She doesn't age.
That happened where she couldn't excel further because she didn't want to do some of the things they wanted her to do. But Maya's
yeah.
been beautiful forever.
Yes,
she is.
I think we're going to get married.
Sporty Barbie, I thought we was doing this together. Like, you down the other
my
shot.
Bad,
and then you said, you know what, give me another one so we can take it together. She over here in the corner.
Well, she
dang,
just,
girl.
Not in
we
the corner.
Slow
she's
down.
In
the
AA
but you
got to
do
me.
It
she's
all.
A,
you guys.
We just, that's how we met each other.
In the corner?
We was
in
the
AA. Dark crowd.
We was in the AA meeting. I was like, baby, you going to get over it? I'm going to get over it.
Do you have mosquitoes in here or something?
When we going to get over this shit? We finally did.
You know when it rains and mosquitoes come out? Okay, you guys got to down it all.
No, come on.
I'm getting mosquito bit.
I'm allergic okay, to mosquitoes.
Okay, what we gonna toast to? You know, to good life, to money.
It was my birthday a month ago.
Good sex and paychecks.
Oh, yeah,
okay.
Sex too.
Celebrate.
Sex too.
Good sex and paychecks.
Threesomes, everything you like. You
six figure paychecks.
Here we go.
Okay.
Six finger.
Yeah, I don't take the whole thing.
I ain't had a
drink
in 3 months, man. This is, I'm about to be.
Don't you put that on us.
I did.
Don't you put that on us.
I can't drink no more.
Because I've been trying to get my vocals. I'm back in the studio singing. So, you know, the alcohol dries your voice out, yeah.
Oh, that's why I don't sound good. See, I knew it was something.
Yeah.
Got to lube it up.
Your cousin. Oh, you said I was with your cousin. Yeah, I was with your cousin. Because, you know, your cousin, that's my dog. We, Chanel West Coast is my cousin.
Okay,
uh-huh. She's mixed?
Yeah. Well, no, see, my cousin, yeah.
I couldn't help it.
I got white cousins, though, for real. I got white cousins, for real, on both
so
sides.
So through the family?
Yeah, in the family. Okay. On both sides, I really got white cousins.
But shout out to Chanel.
Chanel West Coast is, well, my cousin, my baby cousin, they got together.
Oh, okay.
So, you know, they together now, and I'm always at the house, and I will
oh, really?
See your cousin over there. Your cousin, yeah. That's my dog. That's my
He's,
dog.
I be trying to catch up to you. He be like, cousin, the next thing, I'm coming out.
And you got a bunch of cousins.
I'm coming out. I do, but.
That's my dog,
this is,
man. He a real good dude.
He's one of my favorite cousins and stuff. He know what's up.
Man, he a good dude, man.
Yeah. What else? Okay. So we're going to talk about some reality shows. You guys seen, you know, I got to apply my lip gloss. I love it. sorry. Natalie. Oh, okay. Yes. Okay. This is Dollhouse Beauty Bar. Since we mentioned lip gloss,
love
you guys
it.
Can go to dhbeauty.shop
oh, yes.
and make your purchases. We got makeup palettes, eyelashes, apple cider vinegar gummies, that shimmer oil. I was wearing that all in Turks and Caicos, shimmering and all kind of stuff. And then, you know, we got some hair products, too. So get it while you can. Okay.
Hey, that was
thank
dope.
You, Tony.
Hey, come
it.
On. Come on, Sparkle.
Okay, so the reality show producer, Miss Natalie Nunn, is put on blast for cheating on her husband. And, you know, when she first started, I really liked her. Like, you know, she was real cool, humble. But then, I guess, you know, all this fame, she, you know, she joined with the Zeus Network with Lemon Pepper. And
he got a chain. Did y'all see that?
Oh, my God. Did
yes.
he?
He got a chain. Say Lemon Pepper.
Well, shit, he making that money. Let him do what he going to do. Hey,
everybody doing that. You know, Suki got one of Betty Boop. Wait, Belly.
Really?
What's her name? Betty Bop. Betty
is
Boop.
Is that what it is?
No. The dinosaur
booty
from
bop.
Barney.
Stop it.
Wait, she said Booty Bop. Wait, what is her name? You don't even
I
remember
don't know.
It. Who?
Girl.
Tweety Bird?
No, girl. She said Barney.
Suki, they said she looked like the girl, like Barney, the
she
Barney
does.
Sister. So
oh,
she
I know
got
her talking
a chain.
About.
What's her name, though? The sister of
I
Barney.
I don't know. She does, though.
The
I
little dinosaur lady.
That.
She does, but she's cute. Her little chain's cute.
Yeah, okay. Well, go ahead, Suki.
It's cute. So that's what everybody's doing now.
But anyways, no, but Natalie, she's out there, y'all. And we got a little video, right, Tony?
We do.
Okay, we got a video, y'all.
You know, that look.
Baddies, I own that shit. You're a fucking liar. You lie all the fucking time. You lie to your own fucking husband and your family. Don't, like, what are you doing? If you want to risk it all by doing irresponsible things with Curtis in public, go ahead. I'm falling all the way back. I told you before, I don't like him coming to our shit. I don't like him coming to the Bad Boys premiere. I don't like him coming to the Baddies premiere. He's already at the Baddies West premiere just taking pictures on the carpet. I don't want this nigga around my shit. You think you're just gonna keep getting away with the dumb shit you're doing? Then have a real ass conversation with your husband. Hey, yo, I'm fucking Curtis. We together, and that's what it is. I don't give a fuck about. I already fucked.
He fucked everybody.
Lemon Pepper, that's why allegedly he's throwing the chlamydia around or somebody
wow.
throwing
Oh my
around.
God, yes. He's giving everyone diseases.
Allegedly.
Who's that?
Lemmy.
Oh, for real? I didn't know that.
But it's like, how do you
it
fuck?
No, I know Lemmy. I know Lemmy. That's what I say.
Fuck?
I don't know that. For sure. Yeah.
How do you fuck Scotty? Natalie? The other
sound
girl.
Like that DMX song. Keisha. Felicia. No, well, not me.
Yeah, but, they did say Felicia in the song.
Okay, thank you.
They never said my name in none of those songs. So
what does that mean?
I'm just saying. I
ain't. Hey, they did, damn, like, Sophia.
I think I heard Shauna, though.
Glory protect herself. You know what?
You know, I think that was in the Lil Jon song.
Was it? Yeah, my name has been in a few songs.
Yeah, Felicia's famous. Like, the name Felicia is famous.
Embrace it.
I am.
But it's just crazy, like, okay, I just want to know from a man's perspective, why is every poom poom needing to be touched?
Right.
Like, you know what? Why do you always have to just dive into every bitch? Like,
dive.
I feel you on that. That's a yeah, good question. Yeah. That's a great,
And raw dog at that.
Without a snorkel or nothing.
Without a snorkel.
No, that's a great question. I'm not that type of guy. Like, I love women's to be around their
aura?
Company and okay. aura, and I love that, you know.
But do you
energy.
Feel like men feel like it's a duty to just drop dick off? Like, you feel
of,
like you want to please women.
A lot of them
I
do.
Can't ever tell.
A lot of my friends, a lot of friends that off. I know, they'll fuck anything. But to me, I'm very selective. So
is it because you want to please the women, or do you just want to feel the poom poom? Like, which is it?
I just want great energy around me, and I always want women that's around me.
Well, what
does
your male counterpart say about just dropping dick off at every doorstep?
They do it because they don't have no control of what they want to fuck and who they want to fuck. I look at it because
why don't they have control?
You say no to ratchet pussy, Juicy J can't.
Look at she crazy. I come at it as like, man, you know, because I come from a church experience. What you hear from my experience and when you hear about my special is like, you know, I know about spirits and energy. I don't think of it as a physical thing.
That's true.
I don't think of it as a physical thing. So I'm always figuring it out. Even if girls that's around me, I'm figuring it out. Now, the girl going to fuck you if she want to fuck you. She going to fuck you.
That's
so
true.
I take that as it is. I'm not forcing it. I mean, if the pussy get wet, I'm on it. You know what I'm saying?
So you think you exchange spiritual stuff?
That's
she said.
Because when I have sex, it's a moment. It's an energy. It's a moment. So you're gonna have an experience when you have sex with me. It ain't just you're gonna have experience. You're gonna be thinking about me while you at the crib. Your shit gonna be like.
He said she gonna be having flashbacks.
Yeah, but then if you get dickmatized, then you're crazy. So it's like.
Yeah. So I mean, to me, I have more self control. A lot of guys. They want it because I got friends like that. They'll fuck any. I mean,
that's
any
crazy. Terrible. That's scary.
That is terrible. And that's scary.
I'm not like that. I just like I love women. I love women. I just love the experience, the energy around them that they have. Good. That's why I'm always around them, loving, kissing.
So you can have friends without sleeping with them.
I can. Okay. But they gonna give me other girls. So it's like, you know.
Hey, that's a plus.
It's because they gonna tell. Look, like, be like. I'm not gonna fuck him because he's my friend. But
right.
You can fuck up.
He's crazy. See, and I love men that are like that. They're real selective about, you know, who they choose to give their energy, their dick to, and all. Even as a friend,
yeah,
I feel like it says a lot about a person, a man, or and women, but mostly a man, that they can have that self-control and just be like, you know what? No, I don't want your pussy. Like, bitches be like, oh my, well, I'm sorry, not bitches, but women. They'll be like, what? You don't want my pussy? I think that's flattering for a man to turn down some pussy. Like, okay, you got some self-control.
I've got turned down once and I was just that like, is very you're flattering. The best guy I've ever met in my life. Like,
yes, like
you're a godsend.
But then if you have to think about it though, that means it's something that down, you it's, might it's really crazy. Like. Like you have to, you have to, you know, consider that.
They're real particular, you know, and when a man is really particular, it says a lot about
it
him.
Does.
It's like, okay,
it does.
You know, it's something about you, and as a woman, I would want to know more.
Yeah.
You know?
That means they ain't had it all.
But if you don't drop them draws the second time, then we got a problem.
Oh, no, they're going to have to keep it going for plenty of times. It ain't no numbers.
Oh, really?
It's when I say.
What?
So, but see, I'm always, and I'm on the moment. Like, sometimes I have it on the moment. Like, I could be somewhere, and it's just, it's that moment and that energy. I understand it. We could go in the back. It's going to happen. I'm telling you.
In the bathroom?
Yeah, no, I know what you're talking about.
It happens that way. And it ain't me. They pull me. I'll be like, okay, well, shit. Well,
okay. Oh, well, you know what? So
well,
this
is that
goes,
what it is?
So this goes into something that I was going to talk about later, but since we're on the topic, and it's about, like, seducing a man. And, you know, when it comes down to that time, you're in the heat of the moment. Do men like women that pull their drawers down for them during the sex?
No.
Or do they would they rather?
No.
That's a question. Yeah.
It reminds me of that "Don't Be a Menace" yes. when he was in the in the mail truck when she was like raping the guy. You know.
Wait, what was the question again? Who poos? Who's
does men want them? A woman to pull his drawers
like,
off?
Do they like? Oh, do okay, they mind a woman making the first move, basically like seducing the man, making the first move, pulling the drawers?
Oh, you just said be aggressive.
Yeah.
Aggressive. You like a woman to be aggressive. I mean, it depends. Like, it depends on how long we know each other. Mm-hmm. Now, if I just met you and I don't got the energy and you just taking my drawers down, let's go be a goddamn
problem. Now, look,
be a goddamn problem.
We got a video
it's
clip.
Scary. It's scary.
I thought it was so funny. So this is this man's take about a woman taking the first, you know, move. Making the first move on him. So this is Tony, the guy he's talking. And he's like talking about the drawers.
The drawers.
Remember?
Drawers.
I honestly think it scares the man, to be honest.
Okay. We can go back.
Wait,
to
go
that
back.
Though.
I'll rape so him for real.
I'm going to send it to you.
I'm going to drug him and rape him next time I see him.
Okay, but this isn't him. But this is. What's his name? Oh, Dante Rose.
Yes. Give it to me.
Wait a minute.
Gotta be oh my God, 2'10".
Okay.
He is born the same day as me, baby. You gotta get it. Ooh.
I sent it to your phone.
I promise
that you won't wanna get
up
if your home day.
Yeah,
he said, damn.
He's on a microphone.
He said that. Oh, that's my boy.
Damn.
What up, D Weezy?
I sent it to your phone now.
He's well, have you women ever pulled a man's drawers off?
With my teeth.
Marco, was it a man that you knew or was it a random man?
Random? What kind of question is that?
Was it like a one night stand man or was it your man?
I don't do no one night stands.
You never did a one night stand?
Ooh. Is that a song or a question? He was scared to ask.
Have I ever done a one night stand?
It's all about energies. Like, I understand energies. Like, you know. It ain't about, like, it's a feeling, you know. It ain't really, like, I wouldn't call it a one-night stand.
Wait a minute.
You know what I'm saying? It feels like I know you when I do that.
Okay. I've done that. I was doing the opposite. You know what? I have had a one-night stand. But wait a minute. It's hard to explain.
You had to think about
the
it.
The day of this supposedly one-night stand, I was like, you know what? I want to try something different. We were out at an event. Actually, I ain't going to even tell you, but I was like, it's the opposite day. I'm going to do everything the opposite. And usually, like, how I go for a certain type of guy, this was different. I was like, okay, whatever. And it was weird. And so you was actually, don't say nothing, but you was actually there. And it was funny because we had been drinking. I was like, we're going to do the opposite, blah, blah, blah.
It was opposite day.
And like, oh, he's cute. And then it was like the connection.
Yeah.
He's out there in the entertainment stuff or whatever. And he hit me up about some business. And then we came down to do a show. And then, like, the chemistry was just, like, there. I was like, oh, it's opposite day. All of a sudden, I kissed him and shit. I was like, I don't do that. And then.
It's opposite day. Opposite day today.
Only we know what that
means. It was crazy. And, yeah, the opposite day continued.
How did it finish?
It finished.
The aftermath.
The aftermath.
What happened?
It became a beautiful friendship. Like, we're still really good friends.
Why was it just that?
He's a big supporter. What?
Why was it just that? Why wasn't... Oh, it didn't vibe on that type of level?
She giving you them Oprah questions.
Damn. I don't want to go into it.
Yeah,
like
we can't go into it.
Okay.
She got stalkers.
She got real questions.
It was good, but he's got... You know, people have things that are going on. Plus, he lives far. But, you know, he's a great person. He's cool.
Shauna, what about you, girl? Have you took a man's pants off and made the first move?
Of course. She's aggressive.
She a Virgo, though.
She's from Detroit, ain't you? She aggressive.
Virgo women are crazy.
She's from Oklahoma.
She aggressive.
They know what they want. Virgo women know what they want. That's what I will say.
Oh, that is for sure.
Is she aggressive though? You know.
So it took me a few times, but what? I know what I want now. Yeah, you gotta live and you learn, right?
Oh,
yeah.
I thought you were talking about it took you a few times to take the draws out. I'm like, damn, what kind of draws was these?
No.
Okay.
I got a funny story. I turned down sex one time before because I had a rash on my ass. Oh. And
I don't know what the fuck was going on with my ass.
So look, you know, I used to get these pants from the Goodwill and
This is just getting worse.
I had a problem.
Sound like my uncle.
I'm like, what the fuck is going on with my goddamn ass?
It was itchy.
So
you didn't
itchy
wash ass. It.
So I'm like,
wait a minute.
Did you pour cortisone on it?
It ain't got nothing to do with washing. Whoever wore them goddamn pants, and if you out there,
did you wash your pants, the pants before you put them on?
If you out there, Nick, look, you done gave me a rash for three months. I couldn't have sex with this bad ass. She's like, what's wrong with you?
Did you put cortisone?
Cortisone didn't work.
Did you wash it first?
Let me tell you, y'all gotta finish the story. Look,
don't put pants on when I wash.
I gotta finish the story. Okay. So look, it got this rash around. So I'm tripping. I come back home. I say, look, I gotta go see a doctor. I go see a doctor that knows me. That's crazy. She's a lady. I said, look at my ass.
Did you have it like this, or did you have it?
And what did she say was wrong with it?
I don't know. It looks like, you know, this is a woman that knows.
Was it hives?
Like I see, it was from.
It's a woman that knows you. Looking at your ass.
It was a fungus from the pants.
But did it get inside?
No.
Oh, she didn't have to like open it.
No. She had to look at this. But she's a woman that I know. Can you know how embarrassing that shit is?
It still is. I understand.
She said like, oh my God, Pat. Like, you know my name and shit. Oh my God.
But she went to the doctor's office for this.
I went to the doctor.
Yeah, that's got to be very uncomfortable.
Because my ass was itching.
And she said, what kind of fungus was it?
She fixed the shit, though. She gave me the cortisol. And then I went back.
She said, you're allergic to the Goodwill.
Man, I went back to the girl. I was like, baby, I couldn't fuck you. I had a rash on my ass.
You could have just bent her over, though.
No, but she could have grabbed, but she'd be like, what the fuck?
Oh, yeah, because it was lumpy and bumpy.
Don't be bumpy. You don't get your rashy ass.
But I talk about that shit on stage. I really talk about that shit on stage. It's the real. It's the truth. Like, you know, and it was the point of
I'm
my life.
Crying,
I would never
literally.
Go back to Goodwill because I'm so clean. Like, I get tested. I'm clean. I'm a clean person. You know, everything about me, hygiene is incredible. Everything. I go through all the stuff. Like when I talk to women, I say, look, let me see your paperwork. You know what I'm saying? I'm negative.
Yeah.
Let me see
you gotta test three times a year no matter what. Even if someone blows on your shit.
I don't want to play that because I don't want to come into a situation where I don't have a bag, but you give me a bag.
But you know what? Sometimes people say I sat on a seat and it was a disease on the seat. Like
exactly.
It can happen anywhere.
What you sitting on a seat for? Like
no,
that.
But in general, I've heard of people getting like stuff off of dumb shit. So
like crabs or something.
Yeah, something
like weird ass shit.
Yeah, like the guy who stuck his dick in the girl's water bottle. Like
oh
he's
yeah,
tripping.
What
he's
happened?
Tripping.
When your dick could fit in the water bottle?
Stop.
Wait, first of all, yeah, allegedly. That's for real. How and what kind of water bottle?
Hey, she's
and
crazy.
What did they catch? What did they catch off of doing that?
She caught something she can't get rid of.
That's why we can't. This is my home.
That's why you can't leave your water bottle.
Mano. I don't know.
Dick to the mount. She's married and she can't. She has a disease she can't get rid of now because the guy stuck his dick in. You have to
he did it to her.
Yeah.
That's fucked up. He was stuck in her water bottle and she came back and drank it and she said, this don't taste right. That she kept drinking it.
You have to make that sound, though.
She said.
Then she put a camera in and saw the guy humping her water bottle.
Humping her water? That's got to be uncomfortable.
But how does your dick fit in a water bottle?
You have to have a pencil dick.
That's crazy. But we got that video of the man.
Thank God that I don't have one.
Look at you. You're going like this, Felicia. Look.
Yeah,
I'm trying to figure it out.
Nobody likes pencil dicks.
Oh, my God.
Annoying.
Don't ever show us no pencil dick.
Oh, God. When they lay down in the bed. Let me take my drawers off. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't like that. I feel violated when I'm laying down like this, you know what I'm saying? You pulling my drawers off. I gotta lift up like this on you. But now I like when a woman, when I grab a woman's drawer, they lift up. You got me lifting up. You try to pull my drawers off. Don't pull my motherfucking drawers off. Let me take them off. Don't do that shit no more. I happened the other day. I said, damn. And she take, so you gotta think about it. I gotta lift up. Then you pull, I gotta lift my feet up. You take it off my feet. Damn, baby, don't do me like that. That's a violation. So don't take my drawers off, baby. No goddamn more. Let me take my motherfucking drawers off. Shit. I don't like that. Like that. I'm supposed to take off the panties. Don't you take my motherfucking drawers off. No, gotta do this shit. Lift up and then I get it off my feet, or I just pull, keep one leg in. Fuck no.
I don't care. Like, I don't really
who
care.
Who is that? I don't like it. I'm not pulling your drawers off.
But you know what? Sex is like it's, that's with your partner. Whatever y'all want to do, whatever freaky to you, it don't matter. Like it's,
exactly. So why would you? I think
this new baddies group definitely pulls off draws. This new generation of women are just way too fucking
and they
aggressive.
Fucking up their men too. They pulling off the draws. They throwing them in the closets and locking them up.
It's
that's crazy. That's too much.
The roles are reversed.
Beating them up like Krishan.
Women, it's nice to be. You know you. Men like that feminine energy. They don't want nobody coming.
They like that.
Maybe so.
It depends.
Like he was saying earlier, like when
I'm not a soft girl.
It's hard to like stop an attraction and like
you do what you do.
Bleeding up and you've been building up the like you know and it's when you passion. Get to when you finally get to each other, it's like someone's gonna have to make the first move.
That's good.
But if you're just on some like come on just anybody, you know, like but overall, you know. A lot of men have been feminized, so men nowadays do want you to pull off their drawers.
That is true. I think
it's just, you know, it's all about, you know, that freaky moment with that person that you're really with. It don't really matter what y'all do. Yeah. Wait, it do matter.
But if you're dating them, it doesn't matter,
The freak in some people is different from the freak. I talk about this on stage, too. The freaks, it's a lot of freaks in the world. Mm-hmm. Your freak limit.
There's levels.
You ain't sticking shit
sometimes
in my ass.
Sometimes you're doing too much.
You ain't doing none of that.
No, honestly, in L.A.,
it's not
it's
happening.
LA. That's why.
I'm a real man.
I just heard a story of my friend saying he fucked a couple, and then the husband licked his cum off the woman's back.
Wow.
Do you guys watch Queens? Do you guys watch all the Queens Men?
I've seen the first. That's wild. I haven't seen the new one.
I'm on it. Like, I watch all of
that's a freaky ass show.
Do you watch it?
The kids don't watch it.
I love it,
but
it's like the roles are reversed. And I love it because Eve was the boss. And she runs like
the madam.
She's the madam. She is the madam. That's her name. She's the.
You know Vivica is the madam.
I love Vivica. That's my dog.
To men.
She looked like
Vivica has like a whole male review going on.
That's my dog.
Well, you know what? We was talking about dominance and stuff. I'm not dominant, but I'm more of an aggressor. Like are you a soft girl? Are you guys soft girls?
Yeah, I'm dainty. Just throw me around. I don't want to do nothing.
Okay, good night, that guys. Ain't dainty. That's you want the aggression for you. That ain't dainty. She said throw me around.
I like it both, too, but more so.
What y'all are you more cool. dominant as?
For real.
Because I'm more cool. not a soft girl.
No?
No.
So are you gonna be like, give me that? Like,
no. Okay. No, I'm getting it twisted. Soft girl. I'm thinking of like in my day to day life or whatever. No, I'm a little bit more aggressive. I'm not a soft girl.
Like a tomboy.
Yeah.
I feel like I could.
But I'm just like I'm not a soft girl in that era. Like, don't talk to me no type of way. Whatever.
Right.
But in the bedroom, like I can be both. But I'm more like lay there, throw me around. But don't tell me not to put. If I want to do what I want to do, like let me do what I want to do. You know.
Yeah.
I'm gonna take your jaws off if I want to.
What if they don't like it?
No, because they gon' like it or else I won't have them there.
Okay, girl.
Sorry, they gon' like it.
We
like,
got to figure out what is good for a Virgo woman. Cause
another Virgo man.
Really?
I don't meet them, so it's got to be them.
You don't?
No, it's not. You don't want no Virgo
man. No, I do.
These Virgo men, girl.
They're the best in bed, but that's about it.
That's not true.
Yeah, they are. Okay. From an Aquarius, yes.
Y'all don't know she's a thug.
You might want an Aquarius man.
She's a thug. Like, she's a gangster. She's a gangster. She got a little gangster side to her. I seen it. Like, I was there.
Wait,
was you at the premiere? You wasn't at the bat. No. I've seen so many places. And
no, it's just,
things have happened
look,
so many
I
times.
No, like, this is like, see, she, you know, she cute. She's sexy.
She.
But see, what happens, like, you got to be careful in the cute and sexy. Because
please tell me about myself.
The thug might come out. And if the thug come out, you don't know who she know, too. You know, like, okay, nigga, that's what it is. Okay, cud.
We going to say cud.
Hold up.
Cause blood, gangbang.
You don't know what is gonna happen, but she's such a sweetheart, but she got a little thug in her. You know what I'm saying?
More. Oh yes, I want to hear more about myself. I want to see who knows what's really what's like what they peeping about me.
No,
only give so
I read
much.
Very well. I'm a good reader,
hey, give me
especially females.
Girl,
I read
how can they handle sports?
Right.
She my dog too. I watch out for her. I'll be watching out for her.
Thanks you, Patrick. Please. The people that really do care about me, you guys, honestly, like, I love Patrick. I love you guys both. You too, for real. I love you guys. And
I've been in the game for so long, so I watch out for you.
Yeah, thank you. People don't understand. And I just moved here, like, well, I would say recently, but it's been a year and a half now. So, but I've really, like, made genuine connections with people, and you guys are one of them. And I only hang out a few, a handful. Y'all know what I've been through. I see you everywhere. Like I said, we already talked about this. So we've kind of built a connection on that. And I fuck with y'all, so thank you.
Aww.
You're welcome.
We fuck with you, too.
I fuck my friends, too, so if we want to talk about...
Here you go.
I fuck my friends because they stay friends.
What sign are you?
I'm a cusp Libra, Virgo.
The
reason I say that, because people don't understand that. Like, a friend is a friend forever. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, girl, if we friends, let's just be friends. Like, I'm not going to stop your action, but... I want a little some of that, cause that right there. That's
so
like,
you one of these men that be fucking their friends. Man,
but we still friends. We never stop being friends, cause I'm not a jealous type. I'm not insecure. Right.
I like no strings attached. That's fun.
See, that's what's so weary about men that have female friends.
You know, like, we can fuck and not have no jealousy, where are you kind of vibe. You know, I fuck
care.
You and
look,
I see.
I say, take care of yourself.
Well, if you're
you
friends,
come back to me, be negative.
Do you pay bills? No. Well, ain't nobody fucking me unless they helping me with something. Giving me something. Paying something.
Who got weed? No, I'm just joking.
All right, but you got another side to you.
11 side.
Go ahead and say what you were about to say.
I know the persons that do that. I know them.
So you don't care about if they're in a relationship or not? You still gonna fuck them?
I care about everything.
You care about them so much you go ahead and fuck them?
Yeah, because they need
and send them on?
Yeah,
but I'm saying if you think that you...
I'm the side piece.
Do you eat poom poom?
I'm the side piece. I'm the P-E-A-C-E. I'm your piece, baby. When all that motherfucking shit is going on, I'm your piece.
You know, them the ones that get the most pussy, though.
You know, that's crazy.
They the ones to cry on. Definitely get
the and then one like, let me have it, and I'm going to send you on your way, but I'm going to be here when you get back.
I'm giving all my special stuff away, but this is the real shit.
No, but then I'm telling you.
This is what I'm talking about. Like, I'm real life. To me, I come from a background of love, so I don't treat people with, you know, women, like, I have sisters. So a lot of dudes don't have sisters. They don't understand what women are. Mm-hmm. And most people are like, Pat, you hanging around? I have friends always tell me, you ain't fuck her. I said, no, I ain't fucked her. He said, man, you crazy. I was like, nah, it ain't. To me, I just love the energy and be around. And just, it's cool, man. And they going to give me information, what I need. They going to give me some stuff. When I'm doing something wrong, they're going to tell me some stuff that I can get
then
my
when
shit
y'all
right.
Had that little lonely night or whatever.
It may happen,
then...
it may not, but I'm not looking for it.
Because
I look for how you going to, you know, help me.
But what if eventually they grow feelings? The little back and forth, oh, no, because she my friend and you not this way. What if she do that? You can say, you know, but
then
eventually the back and forth, women are more emotional than men.
Yeah.
True.
So eventually, what
men
if she
turn
hits
it
you
off.
With that?
They can say,
and
oh,
then you
it
really,
ain't
you is you really still on that friendship vibe? You really not even.
We'll work it out because I'm always gonna be cool. Like it's, I'm telling you, like I always be.
So
cool.
If she wants more,
it's just gonna always be that.
I'm a fun. Like if you ask anyone that ever hanged around me, women that hang around me, they love to be around me because I'm a fun guy. I'm gonna keep you laughing. We're gonna have
okay,
a good time.
But. If she, so you guys are doing this back and forth, but you're long-term friends. But what if she gains feelings and she wants more? Then what you gonna do?
We gonna take care of them feelings. But
ooh,
we still
how?
Be cool
because what do you mean?
I'm gonna make sure everything's gonna be good. I know how to do it. Like I.
Okay. Yeah, you know.
I've been doing this.
Men
for
be
years.
Having this. I know what to do when the
I've been like this all my life. Like I'm a Libra. I'm a Libra. Women, we were naturally like I don't know how it is, but we're naturally connected to. The female, like we don't like toxic energy. We don't like animosity. We don't like none of. We don't like arguments. We don't like none of that. But we know how to cultivate our circle with the women that we like and their energies to make us feel like we want to feel because we a king. So we feel that way. We want to feel to make them feel like a queen. Anybody fucking with you? But I was like, hey, baby, you like go ahead, you know, do your thing. I'm not. But I'm saying, don't bring me no shit. Like if he got good energy. You do your thing, but come back to me and make sure you good. But don't bring me no bad energy.
But you get into the shit, don't you?
Energies, huh?
You do get into the shit, don't you?
Get into what?
If they not purposely trying to bring you the energy, but if you fucking with them and they, oh, you're my friend and I need some release, help me.
Of course, she said. Look, we're friends.
Now
like,
what?
What is the
but
friendship?
Then you said don't bring that energy.
No, I want
so what if
energy.
That? Yeah, she bringing the good energy, and y'all got good energy, and y'all getting good energy. But on the back burner, like she got somebody there, and she's bringing in that negative energy because
I recognize that. But like,
so you're going to have to, like, shut it down. You ever had to block somebody or shut it down?
I won't shut it down because I'm still a friend. Like, I'm still.
So you still going to be there? He not answered the question.
Yeah, he bounced.
You said
he
Oprah. He, like, I'm Oprah.
Yeah, you are Oprah. Because you sorry, got, you got other questions, two questions.
Like, we need a question. We need a part two.
What's the question you was going to ask?
Okay, what is Mr. Nigiru? Is that how you say it? What does he think about
what
all
is,
this?
What is the craziest thing about it is that
you know, we got a little video. Look, we got a video we're gonna play real quick, and then we're gonna close it out because we have to show this. This is what Mr. Nigiru think about the women.
Most of all, I stay away from ghetto bitches. Yes, and I say ghetto bitches because ghetto, you know what I'm talking about, loud mouth, attitude, grabbing air. You see the ones that love to grab air. Using their hand movements, grabbing and talking and pointing aggressively. Not only grabbing, but rolling eyes and rolling necks. I stay away from that chicken head type of mentality. Add 30 to 40 years to your life. Watch who you are around.
40.
Ooh,
that
chicken head.
That's Nigiru. He giving you some knowledge.
I was like the talking, catching the air. I didn't know, and then I see. I was like, oh no.
That's you?
No, that's me. Yeah, that's the character. That's one of my characters.
Oh, that's you?
Show up like that.
I didn't know who that was.
That's the character. That's one of my characters.
She said, that's you.
Everybody, I'm going to need you to show up like that one day.
That's my guy.
His alter like, ego.
With no drawers on underneath.
Ooh,
on. Oh, Lord. He said, ooh, come on. He was
like
excited.
But nobody has to pull him off.
Yep, it's open.
All right. Okay, so go ahead and tell everybody what y'all about to do. I mean, you know.
Okay, where's your next special coming out?
My next show, I'll be at the Improv sometime this month, but my special will be, we're shooting it in April. I have the dates, and I'm sitting on private events. Sophia's going to be there. We already know that. We already know. Sparkle's going to be there.
We all going to be there.
Sporty's going to be there.
Sporty's going to be there. I mean, it's going to be a beautiful thing because it's going to be a lot of women in the building, but it's a nice facility.
You're going to make sure of that.
When is this again?
It's going to be in April. I have the dates coming soon. It's the dates. Cool. But it's going to be like a big experience. You know, it's drinks. It's going to be food. But it's going to be a good time. It's going to be a good, like, 4 hours. I got two shows, 7:30, and then I have another one at 8. I think it's 8:30, 9:30. So it's
nice.
Two different shows.
Okay.
So, you know, it's a private event. Only real people in great energy can come through. And other than that, I'm just trying to live life.
Just that good energy.
Yeah, good energy, love, happiness. That's what I am. So I want all that in the building. And I'm going to have my apparel, my clothes, and stuff that you can buy. But everything else I'm doing is movies. I got films and sitcoms coming. We haven't started filming yet. I can't really talk about that yet. But, I mean, God is good, and that's all I'm doing, just living my life.
Yay. Okay. Yay. Well, you know what? I'm so proud of you, Patrick, because you be out here doing your shit.
You're gonna
make
me cry,
man. No, don't do that. Don't do that. But, you know, you really own your shit, and you're really all about that positive energy. Like, you don't go just anywhere. You know, you make sure your time is spent well. Mm-hmm. And that's dope.
So I can spend my time with you and make it well. Oh, did I say that shit out loud? I thought that was a mental.
You so crazy, Patrick.
I appreciate y'all, man. Precious. Yes. So, you know, look, y'all my people. Y'all know it. Every time
been
I see y'all.
Forever.
Oh, man, it's love.
We out here
we
in Hollywood.
Already know. I fuck and with y'all regardless. Like, if you were the dude, I'd be seeing it. Like, I'd be like, okay. But you still don't know. She fuck with me too, homie.
What?
And that's cool. No, I'm just like,
what the hell?
The moral of the whole story today.
I'm just playing. Let me stop. I just said what I said. I'm done.
Okay. He like to keep going and going. And Sporty Barbie, thank you for coming today. It's always a pleasure to have you.
Thank you for having me.
Yes. Hopefully everybody
love
have
you guys.
Fun. Love you too. And Sophie, what's your closing out?
We
it
love
is
Sophie
birthday.
And her titties.
We lit today. And these titties are real. And no one can suck them.
That's but right.
Sophie
that
and her titties.
You can suck them for your birthday. You want them thrown in your mouth?
I want to see.
Right now?
We
did this last time.
We're not going to do this.
Right now? Whose birthday is it?
It's her birthday.
It's your birthday today?
It's not today. It was last
night. No,
oh,
because
man.
She ran off.
We gotta
so we're
get you
celebrating
drink, man.
It today.
We
Sophia
go out.
Makes that shit last
She's
like
crazy.
A month or two.
We gotta go out, Sparkle.
If it's your birthday,
some.
it's a month or two. All
right. It's closing out the show because we're going to keep it going forever.
Hey, can I say something? Y'all had one of the homies on Columbus Short. That's my dog.
Okay.
Hey, bro, love you, man, because he's one of the real ones in the game, man. Love you, bro. All right. I just had to say that because y'all had one of them.
Okay. Next time, we'll call him online.
We ready to go?
Okay, shots.
We ready to go? Thank you. This is Champagne Waves.
I'm empty.
Tune in for next. This girl.
We can't tune in until we. No, bye.